What is up guys and welcome back to my channel. In this video I am going to be taking you to explore Dubai. The city of Dubai needs no introduction. The metropolitan hub where the east meets the west, this is a city that sprang up from the desert and has grown phenomenally over the past 50 years. When you think of Dubai today, we imagine a futuristic city with an array of skyscrapers on the backdrop of the desert sunset. But before becoming the cosmopolitan hub that it is today, these dunes were home to a small population of merchants and pearl divers who lived a rather modest life in the deserts of the Middle East. So to start off our Dubai series, let's visit a place that has reserved its charm of old Dubai. No, thank you. I'm just going to look around. Thanks.
I'll give you a nice dress. You can take nice pictures. Yes.
Ah, welcome back.
Okay. Yes, yes, yes.
Hello, ma'am.
Hi, hi.
Spice here, sandalwood, bakur, spice.
Yes, madam ji. One of
mine. Oh, fine. Thank you.
That's fine.
No. That's fine. I have one like that.
Yes.
That's fine. She's like, take it one. Take one more. Dubai, you're going to start hearing the word souq being thrown around a lot. With good reason, but what a souq really means is an Arab marketplace or a bazaar. And for a city that developed around trade so much, souqs are such an integral part of the lifeblood of the city. It's more than just trade, it's culture, it's gathering, it's entertainment, and it's the place where people used to come and make an announcement about marriage, whether it was for the children to come and learn about trade, for entertainment, to hear the stories of all the merchants that came here. So this is a very, very important place in the city. It's almost like the heartbeat of Dubai city. So interestingly enough, this gold souq was established before the UAE, making this a driving force behind economy and trade way before the country was even established. So Dubai was actually called the city of gold back in that time, and I don't see why it can't be called the city of gold even now. So naturally, gold is a huge cultural aspect here as well. And what you see behind me is some of the ornaments that they adorn themselves in during their wedding season, which is spectacular. I haven't seen anything like that before. So very interesting. But also this is a place where you can pick up some really unique pieces, whether it's bespoke or maybe some Arabian inspired pieces, maybe something to remember your trip by. So definitely drop by here, and remember, prices aren't set in stone, so you can drive a hard bargain. Now we are at the Spice Souq, which is a very close neighbor of the Gold Souq, and the moment you set foot on the trade floor, it smells so fragrant, so amazing, and everywhere you look there's vibrantly colored spices I've never seen before in my life. Among other things, they also have incense and perfumes, candied fruits, rice, herbs, anything you can think of, they've got it all here. And they have expert perfumers that can blend you your personalized concoction and bottle it just for you. So that's a very, very interesting thing that I'm definitely going to try, I think.
See this one, the charcoal for Taham. The white one, like a zebra, like
okay.
This. Okay, stay strong, close eyes. One, two, three.
Whoa!
It's very good for eyes, for nose, for sinuses. For
wow!
Face.
My eyes!
This is all the teas, and that one is saffron.
Saffron, yeah.
Original saffron from Iraq.
Mm-hmm.
I take this here, I put.
Yeah.
And I broke this.
Oh.
I'll show you.
Oh my god. Wow. City Center's very own sports bar. So as you can see, La Fabrique has an amazing menu here, as well as some incredibly creative cocktails. I love this one specifically, the Earl Grey whiskey sour. Delicious, highly recommend, you should totally try it. And it honestly sets the best environment for you to come and catch your game, regardless of whether you're on holiday or not. Who says you have to miss your game, right? So for our Dubai series, we've decided to partner up with Majid Al Futtaim's Accor Hotels. And let me show you guys why. The Accor Group of Hotels is one of the leading hotel chains in the world, with a number of prominent hotel brands varying for every budget. In this series, we will be staying at four of them, starting with the Pullman Dubai Creek City Center Hotel. Their five-star property, which is a cosmopolitan traveler's haven, and is a great place for those of you looking to combine work with pleasure. Good morning, guys. Let me show you our room. Looks absolutely amazing, guys. I cannot wait to begin. So this kind of breakfast in bed is something that Pullman arranges for a special occasion. But usually for breakfast, you can go down to the restaurant for a hot breakfast. Or if you're on the 11th floor, you have an executive lounge where you can have a cold breakfast there and maybe order in a few things from the restaurant downstairs. So there's a variety of options. And I intend on exploring all of them, but first, I'm gonna dig in. So one of my favorite things about this hotel is the fact that it is connected to the Deira city center, and you actually have access directly from within the hotel's second floor, right inside the mall, so you never have to step out. This mall is a great place for shopping on this side of town, and while it may not be as large as some of the other malls you will find in Dubai, you will definitely not have any trouble finding all the brands and necessities you're looking for, albeit at a smaller size. Which really is not a bad thing, because you can actually cover a decent area of this mall without feeling like you just ran a marathon. It also has a direct link to the metro, making it very convenient in terms of travel. Thank you. We are on the Dubai Creek now, you guys. It is so beautiful. And this place has been a very important place for the locals of this area, including the early settlers of this city. The first port is also located here, as well as there was a thriving pearling industry back in the day. Today, it is still a very lively location, and currently we are crossing from Deira, Dubai to Bur, Dubai. And it's very interesting because you have the contrast of the very futuristic buildings here, as well as some of the very older buildings on this side as well. We are crossing the creek on an Abra, which is a traditional wooden boat that has been used for many, many years to cross the creek. And it is still being used by locals in this area as a form of transport back and forth. And I think that one, it's one of the most beautiful rides that you can experience here, as well as it is one of the most authentic experiences that you can have here in Dubai, while also being a very cheap activity to do here, usually costing from about 1 to 2 dirhams to cross with a group of people. But if you want to hire a boat for yourself for half an hour just to go around and explore the area, that'll be about 60 dirhams as well. Now I'm taking you to explore Al Seef, which is a very unique place here in Dubai. Al Seef is a beautiful, bustling destination in Bur, Dubai, which blends contemporary architecture with its historical touches. It takes a great deal of influence from the Al Fahidi historical neighborhood, which was built by Persian merchants who were attracted by the rich trade opportunities provided by the Emirati government. In the 1980s, half of the Al Fahidi neighborhood was destroyed to make way for new developments. And in 1989, the remaining parts of the neighborhood were to be demolished when Rainer Otter, a British architect who was living in the neighborhood, started a campaign to preserve the area. He wrote to Prince Charles, who was scheduled to visit Dubai that year. And on his arrival, Prince Charles requested to visit Al Fahidi, during which he suggested that perhaps the neighborhood should be preserved. And so the demolition was cancelled. What I love the most about this neighborhood is that not only does it show how far Dubai has come in such a short period of time, but also adds even more depth to your experience in the city, almost like you're time traveling between Dubai of the past and the future. Tea Lounge by Dilmah. This is a very special place for me, and of course a very familiar name in the tea industry. It's very well known, and this concept is very special and unique to Pullman Dubai Creek City Center. You can only find this concept here, so if you'd like to try some of the finest tea there is, you'll have to come here. And what's special about this place is that they have a wonderful menu that with a lot of dishes that are infused as well as paired with the perfect tea to bring out those special flavors. So what we have here is their artful afternoon high tea, and we have quite a few delicious treats here like the tea infused scones as well as some regular scones. And a very special thing here is the George Keat art inspired moist chocolate cake. Now I actually tried that early on, it's very delicious. Speaking of art inspired, the Tea Lounge by Dilmah also houses the Artist Playground by Pullman. This is a wonderful concept that allows local designers and artists to come and showcase or exhibit their work. So this is a fine place for you to enjoy the world's finest tea, their mixology and their gastronomy while experiencing some beautiful artworks. addition to trying the 20 different types of tea that are available here at the lounge, here at the tasting table, you can also try them before purchasing them. Okay, so I couldn't resist just not going to the spa, so I booked myself into something called the Heaven on Earth package, which has a deep tissue massage as well as a detoxifying facial called the City Life facial. Sounds very interesting and promising. I'm very excited. One thing I did not expect is how much walking we would be doing while exploring Dubai. And it's times like these that really make me appreciate a relaxing massage to ease off the stress and refresh me for the many more days of exploring ahead. So with that, we've come to the end of this vlog. Thank you so much for watching until the end, you guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. We've got heaps more exploring to share with you on our Dubai series, so stay tuned for next week's vlog. And make sure you hit that subscribe button, like this video, and make sure you hit the bell notification so that you won't miss out on next week's upload. And with that, I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!